Jackson.
Oh, you're so awesome.
Yeah, and she's keeping her eye open for the tools. She's just going to give it to us.
Woohoo!
Okay.
So we're going to make some tutus.
I'll call you when I get there.
Okay.
Okay, I'm not doing babysitting with Lissette and shit, just so you know.
Me neither, but...
Yeah, I mean, he wanted me to babysit. You decide what you're going to do. You know what? He said he'd call the cops on her unless she slept with him.
I know. I asked if I should answer it.
We can go back if you want.
What do you mean?
Or do you have to wait here?
I still have to go in there.
Hello?
Hello?
What are you doing?
I'm sitting in my car.
Doing what?
Just waiting to pee.
Oh.
What are you doing?
Nothing, just sitting at
Roscoe's. You sound sad.
I'm alright.
Are you sure?
I have a question, though.
What's that?
Will you take me to Walmart to pick up a prescription in North Avenue?
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
Yeah, I can do that.
Okay.
But I have to wait.
After you pee?
Yeah, I'm waiting to pee.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, see you in a little bit.
Okay, love you, bye.
Okay, love you, bye.
So I could either take you home or we could get Amanda first.
I'll probably head home. Because I've got a lot of footage to edit and there's already a ton of footage.
Okay. Well, I'm going to go wait.
Okay.
With the peeps. I'm your peeps. I'm not gonna oh. I'd love it in there.
Okay, well tell your peeps I said hi.
I'd love it in there. It's fun. I come here just to hang out.
I do too.
Yeah.
It's a cool place to chill.
I know. Really?
No.
It really sucks. So I just take, that's my joke every time I come in here. I'm not even supposed to be here. I tell everybody, I'm like, I'm not even supposed to be here. I just come here to hang out. They're just like all looking at me. You know, just like, yeah, this is the place.
Cool. All right, Kat.
That's a lot of attention.
Coming back. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
That's
you were fine.
What happens in there? I start wondering if I'm ever gonna get.
Whether if you're ever gonna get out of there. Yeah.
So 5 and 15 minutes later.
It actually wasn't
that's
that
like
long.
20 minutes.
I think we've waited longer. It was all good.
Thank
it wasn't
you
that big a deal. Oh, yeah. We had to get a stop in. For shizzle. That was funny when we went in Metro PCS. Those guys were like, what the heck?
I know. Did you see their faces?
They're like, who are these guys?
I didn't know what to say. And then, like, they just started staring at you in the camera.
Oh, I know.
And they're then really I just started flipping. I kind of started laughing because I thought it was funny. And then the one guy started smiling.
Yeah. It's
like, they just didn't know what to say.
Yeah, they didn't know whether to say no camera or what are you doing. Or
we didn't even ask permission.
No, we just waltzed right in, got the shot, and waltzed right out.
Some of those people I bet are pretty funny. I think some of them might be comedians that work in there. We should have asked them
if they were actual comedians. Yeah.
No, I'm serious.
They probably knew
some. I might have heard some jokes.
They probably knew some jokes.
I'm pretty sure they do.
I think two of the jokes I know that I'm thinking of right now are not appropriate for the internet.
Dora. If it's not appropriate for the internet, it's not appropriate for you.
Well, I was on the internet when I found out about it. Do you?
We're gonna have to put restrictions.
My mom already knows about it.
We're gonna put like
my mom tells me
parental controls is what we need.
I think I already told you it too.
Yeah, I think
the elephant joke.
Let's not hear it. We'd have to edit it out and then that would.
Is this like dirty stuff? Are you
ha ha. that one elephant said to the other, how does he feed himself with that thing?
Oh, that's kind of funny, but I'm going to have to edit it out.
Really?
Probably, yeah.
Is it that bad?
It's not that bad, but...
The worst thing they say is it's vegan.
It's weird about what they will, what you say, and not what you say.
Yeah, that's okay.
We're good.
I'm sorry, then.
No, no worries. You're... It may. I doubt it.
You doubt it?
I don't know. I'm thinking about
it. I don't know. I run around talking about vaginas.
Well, yeah.
Like, on the webisode.
That's true. Okay.
On the webisode.
Then we should be fine.
I say vagina power
to my friends.
I just get a little paranoid about, like, what you can and can't say on the internet, because I never know.
Did you get sued or something?
No, I wouldn't get sued. I wouldn't even... They'd just probably drop the episode till I took out the scene.
But we so got away with vagina stuff.
Yeah, they would... They don't mind that.
Why would they mind naked, then?
I don't know. Maybe not. I think this discussion alone will, once they hear this discussion, they'll be like, well, we gotta leave it now because they discussed it.
I got another one that's appropriate.
What?
So Joe and Frankie met up after school. Frankie said to Joe, oh man, I had the best weekend. I went to this party and their toilets were made of pure gold. He said, Joe said, no way. He said, yeah, way. Here, I'll come show you. Come on. So they went to the house and they knocked, and then a middle-aged lady answers the door. And then Frankie says, I'm sorry to Boogeyman, but my friend didn't believe me when I told him that you have toilets made out of gold. She stared at him for a while. Then she yelled in the house, John, the guy who pooped in your trombone is here.
Oh, that's funny.
That is.
The most controversial episode so far.
Because I told her I was taking you to Main Street instead of taking you other places.
Now we're on a cliff then, and then you gotta go see. It's okay though, it added flavor to
it. No texting or anything while driving.
What are you talking about?
That's correct, okay, but just look over there. I did not go to Main Street. Instead, I went and paid my phone bill and took a UA.
Okay.
So I'm just letting you know where I'm taking Aaron home.
Oh, are you guys done?
Just about, yeah. As soon as we drop him off, we're going to be done.
Well, if you guys could let me know scheduling, like, today. Like, let me know ahead, so.
Yeah.
What day's open for everybody next week? What day is open for everybody?
I'll let you know as soon as Aaron and I discuss it next week.
Yeah, we'll figure it out.
I think I did let you know. Oh, no, that was last week. Never mind. Never mind.
Yeah, because you know what you said last time is you were
going to
let him know you thought Friday, but you weren't for sure. But
yeah, but that was last week. That was a totally different week.
Last week. See, you guys really messed me up. Nice meeting you, Aaron.
That's
nice meeting you, too. You're awesome. We'll get you on the episode next week, hopefully.
Yeah, so I'll let you know. Next week, I might be at my dad's. I don't know yet.
One day at a time.
I don't know if I'm allowed to have friends over there. Yeah, we can moon each other and stuff, but we're going to do that. Yeah, with our cats on. Oh, so yeah, I'm taking Aaron out to Cliff, and I'm just notifying you where I'm bringing your kid, since I have your kid.
I trust you.
Okay.
I trust you.
Okay.
I trust you. You've earned trust.
Okay.
Well, I'm not worried about you kidnapping.
The most controversial episode continues on.
Yes. That's fun. I need to find that Phantom of the Opera. Wait a minute, I paid my phone bill.
Oh yeah, let's hear some, let's hear some music.
To
that
music.
Means right before we finish.
It's
we
about can... to go down.
It's about to go down.
Did we ever listen to it? I have Ozzy Osbourne CD. We should have listened to that earlier. But we can do that next round. We'll just play some Ozzy in the background. But does Ozzy go through it if we try
I
that?
I think Ozzy will work, yeah.
But I got Leonard, some... Leonard Skinner doesn't go through.
Yeah, I don't know. It's all weird. It'll show me what didn't go through, and I'll just delete it out if I have to or add music.
I say we play more Thomas Gabriel.
That sounds good
I
to me.
Want to.
We played that this morning. Did you hear?
Yeah, I did. And then Matt's all like, is Eric down there? Does Kinder have Eric down there? And I was like, no, it's Thomas. Thomas Gabriel. Stop. Is what you hear down there. And he's like, no.
Yep. I wonder if my best friend will see this.
Probably if you tell her about
this
it.
This is going to be Webisode
17.
Is it okay if I mention her name?
Go for it.
My best friend, Miranda Redding. Well,
first state your what name you want to use in the show.
Miranda.
Okay, and what's your friend?
Miranda Redding.
Oh, cool. Okay.
Okay, we're just
going to
take it to the top.
Miranda's my best friend. You remember Miranda, right?
And watch them go.
Yeah,
YouTube kids.
Yeah, she's Mindy's daughter.
Yeah, I met her before.
If she sees this, she's gonna freak out because I mentioned her.
She's gonna flip, dude. She's gonna come after
us. In the shadow of a corner store, as the night was growing cold, I heard an old man crying out.
Hopefully this one gets through.
Everything.
Oh, it'll all get through. It'll all get through. One of these days.
The wheels that make this world go round, everything must be sold. The dollar, euro, yen, and pound, everything must be sold. Whiskey, watches, wool, and war, everything must be sold. To the sodded prince and the man next door, everything must be sold. Everything must be sold.
Oh, I saw you.
Mountains, water, air, and sea, everything must be sold. Big profits selling what was free, everything must be sold. Adoring fans around the stage, everything must be sold. The latest idol of this age, everything must be sold. Love is just a fairy tale, and everything must be sold.
Sorry, ma'am.
Lexi's going.
The virgin lambs began to bear.
That was scaring the people.
That was scared her. I'm gonna get kicked out now. No, I'm kidding. Hey, Ashley.
Archers wake the drum.
When would you like to reconvene for 18?
You know, we're gonna have to. I might be living with my kids by then, so we should just take it day by day.
Okay, I'll call you sometime soon.
Yeah.
Or you can call me sometime soon.
Yeah.
And if whatever happens, happens.
Yeah, because we'll be conversating.
Sounds good to me. We'll be in talk.
Amazing grace cannot be.
We'll be in conversation.
Yes.
Love you, cousin.
Grace cannot be so.
Yeah. By the way, did I do anything that offended you today?
No.
You okay, good.
The world, why? Do I? Am I
no,
out
no,
like
no,
that?
Not at all. I just don't want to end the show everything on a bad must. Note.
No, it's not a good note.
We'll keep going so. With the we'll keep going with the show if we can. If we have to take a break, or we'll just see what day we have a couple
well,
free
you know
hours.
What? We might just have to do it early in the day.
We can do that.
Probably a plan.
We can even do that in the morning.
And I might technically be working.
Okay. We can even do it in the morning.
On the webisode, yes.
Ah, we'll figure it out.
Okay.
But we've got to do 18. And then 19. And then 20. I'm a mad director.
I'll do my best.
I'm a mad director.
I'll do my best.
I never stop.
Did I do a bad job? No, you did great.
You did awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, that was awesome. Good guest star. State your name again.
Diora.
Cool. See y'all later. Love ya. Hey, Carl.
How are you, my friend?
Good. How are you doing?
Okay.
I'm going to have to call the Screen Actors Guild again for this footage.
Hi, Kaylee. Okay, how are you? Thank you.
We'll be right back.
I feel a rush. We clutch, it isn't much, but it's enough to make me wonder what's in store for us. It's lust, it's torturous. You must be a sorceress, cause you just did the impossible. Gain my trust. Don't play games, it'll be dangerous if you fuck me over. Cause if I get burnt, I'ma show you what it's like to hurt. Cause I've been treated like dirt before you, and love is evil. Spell it backwards, I'll show you.
Until next week, my cousins, stay groovy. By the way, speaking of the man who will not be named, I'll be by to drop by in a couple of weeks, but we'll probably have a show or two done by then, too, because I'm still all good. But it's all good in the hood. Anyway, y'all have a good one.
You too.
Thanks for doing the show.
Yeah.
We'll see you next time. Okay.
Warrior.
I feel a rush. We clutch, it isn't much, but it's enough to make me wonder what's in store for us. It's lust, it's torturous. You must be a sorceress, cause you just did the impossible. Gain my trust. Don't play games, it'll be dangerous if you fuck me over. Cause if I get burnt, I'ma show you what it's like to hurt. Cause I've been treated like dirt before you, and love is evil. Spell it backwards, I'll show you.
Until next week, my cousins, stay groovy. By the way, speaking of the man who will not be named, I'll be by to drop by in a couple of weeks, but we'll probably have a show or two done by then, too, because I'm still all good. But it's all good in the hood. Anyway, y'all have a good one.
You too.
Thanks for doing the show.
Yeah.
We'll see you next time. And cut. All right, guys.
Oh.
All right. Hey. Don't ask me whether this is the beginning or the end. Or the end or the beginning. Just joking.
All right. I love you.
Love ya.
See ya.
See you in a few. Oh, wait. Did I get everything? Yeah, it looks like it.
Ruger.
Laters.
You gotta get Ruger in there.
Oh, yeah. Of course. Ruger's is... And shot. Rugs is going, you're going out there in that wind. It's going to knock me over, dude. I'm so skinny that it'll knock me over.
Happy filming.
Yeah, it's going to be exciting here in the wind in a minute. I may have to yell cut before anybody can even hear me say it.
Bye.
Love you. I'll see you later.
Come on.
Vietnam. Oh, here we go.
So I think we're going to hold off on and Thomas Gabriel's episode because I don't want to have the horror film
be part of that. So
yeah.
Here's an idea I have that can go on film.
Okay.
Right now I'm kind of banking everything on episode 16.
I'll tell 16?
We're going to go to 52. But I'm banking everything lately on getting to episode 16, and I'll tell you why.
Okay, bye.
We'll be out of the horror episodes. It'll be longer than any other project I've ever partaken by 16. And then it'll have more views than any other project I've ever had by 16. And we could use the 16th one for Thomas Gabriel, since it is late. But then when we get to 19, if you can believe it or not, I'm going to do this thing called the mid-season finale. Not like a clip show or anything, but like we'll do like a mid... Because last night I was watching The Walking Dead and they have mid-season finales. We're going to do that with season 2. So 19 is the mid-season finale. So 16 and 19 are big episodes.
Wow.
Because with this one, we're still getting a little bit of the behind the scenes of the horror film, which is going to look way different than our episodes. Trust me, it's going to be completely different. But when you do the making of, and I've got all the pages marked I need to film today, when you do the making of and it crosses over, then it takes up an episode of both. It's like part of Orgy of the Damned, but it's also Two Badass Biznitiches. So by the time we get to 16, we'll be out of the woods with the horror film, and we'll be at the record-breaking episode anyway, which I think I kind of played just right. So I think we're okay. I think we'll be okay. I know we got a lot of badass Biznitiches to go. And that's cool. Because, like, we need to make that show till the end of time.
And we have ideas for next
year. Yeah, I was going to say, we need...
But we're not going to ruin that, but we're spicing it up.
No. And at the same time, the cool thing about the ideas is that we can use them, and then we usually end up getting better ones anyway by the end of the episode. Like, we're very good at conquering the world with just the footage we have. Megan's going to meet us over there.
Yeah. Oh, we got to get change, though.
Oh, okay.
Because I only have his big bills.
Okay. That's fine. We can do that. We're getting
extra.
Should
we get a Mountain Dew or something, or what do you want?
All the energy, 5-hour energies?
Not for me, no more.
I'll just take one.
You can have one.
Just one, maybe. I don't know.
Actually, I think there's one back there somewhere.
Is there? There might be.
Yeah, I saw it yesterday. There is one back there.
Interesting.
I had such a stomach ache.
Did you? After the 5-hour energy?
After the 4 or 5 hour? 4.
Yeah, we had a lot that one day. It's all on film.
You didn't feel like crap?
I couldn't count how many we had on film.
You didn't feel like crap that day?
I think I had a little too much, but we also climbed a mountain that day, or a hill, not really a mountain, but a hill. We climbed a mountain, actually. So when I had all the 5-hour energies and climbed a mountain, yeah, I was feeling a little queasy.
Woo,
by the end of it, you know what I mean? Like, I was...
No, I just felt like shit the next day.
Oh, dude. For, like, 3 days, I was feeling shit.
Oh, my God, yeah. And it was the 5-hour energy, I know.
Well, I know, but we also climbed a mountain on it. So that could have affected us the next few days, too. See what I'm saying? Uh-oh. Secret business with the police.
No, I'm okay.
Not only is she done with her character, you and I only have about 5 or 6 lines to shoot, Ashley. And then we're good for today because we already got Amanda drinking the potion, which was like easy to get.
Yeah.
Cool.
So we're good. We are golden.
Oh yeah, I have money.
I have a hard time remembering things.
That's
my brain.
Okay. I like your sparkles.
The sparkles are off of the... Cape.
Oh, I thought it was like in that. Falling. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Yeah. Well, thank you for everything that you did.
Yeah.
Thanks for helping us out. Yeah. That really helped. I forgot to give her my speech about how to think about deep thoughts, but she was thinking about deep thoughts, I could tell.
She's deep.
She thinks deep without being told to think deep.
Oh my God, yeah.
I do.
So that's all good. So don't we all, as Sheelys? Deeply think. Deep thinkers.
Like, I'm always thinking about complicated shit. Very analytical.
Analytics is good.
I'll just teach ya.
You gotta go run to the bathroom.
Go like this.
Yes! Pterodactyls reunite! I was all faced by Felicia. She's like, stop saying that gay shit! She's all...
Oh my god. Do the bird call.
How's she doing? Felicia.
Now that we're on camera, we're on the set of two badass biz bitches right now. Come on, do the pterodactyl. Do the pterodactyl. Yes!
Pretty good, pretty good.
Pterodactyls, reunite!
Oh my god. Oh my gosh, that was great.
That would be funny to have Felicia here and just like, stop saying that gay shit. I was like, whatever, dude.
Alright, I'm gonna take
She's off. Okay. She had an Alex in her life. And,
thank you, Megan.
You're 7 years. Of course.
That was good.
Yeah, of course.
Easy and breezy.
Oh, you're my baby. Hi.
Love you.
Love you too. You're the baby. Oh, okay.
I hope I got that. You're I'm just kidding.
You're like my older sister. All right.
She's going to be the lead singer. Can you show him?
He knows I sing.
No, you're on my show right now.
I don't want to sing right now.
Please?
No.
Come on, baby. Show them what they got.
I'm going to go.
And can you do it next webisode?
Yeah.
Really? I'm going to start being on my webisode.
Maybe. Just let me know.
Look how excited I am. She says yes.
Bye. Thank you.
You're welcome.
She said yes.
When it's up and going, I want to see it.
Oh, you'll be one of the first to know.
All right. Cool.
Woohoo.
So, we're already almost on a mission out of here. We just need to do one scene.
Pull my car up. Yes.
You got the beverages.
Thank you.
He says he understands that I just like to talk about pterodactyls because it's fun.
Good. There's a good reason for everything, I think.
He says he can understand that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shit. I forgot what I was going to do.
Is Amanda coming?
Yeah, she says give her a minute and a half to heat up some food.
Okay. Minute and a half
that's
it is.
That's my horse scream.
Whoa, that almost broke the camera. No, I'm kidding.
That was intense. It almost broke my eardrum.
Yeah.
Because it was like an internal
was it piercing. It probably broke the speaker. No, I'm kidding.
Was it piercing? It pierced my ears.
I'm pierced.
Me too.
I'm still in a pierced state.
That. I think that people like pierced.
I think piercing is good.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know if we should cut till we're driving out. We should. All right, action.
I am strong and you are young. We together, ye cast over.
Haley, I hear this weird rumor you're not camera shy. Could you please demonstrate, please?
Well, I was the main camera crew lead person, I forgot the term for it, for my middle school TV series. And I would go out in public and I'd get advertisement to show up and give us money and all this really cool stuff. And I'd go around to, like, city things that happened, like, tonight, like the Christmas tree lighting and Santa Claus lighting the Christmas tree and all Main Street trees and all this really cool stuff. I would record that and we would use that for our news clips that we had during middle school. It was a lot of fun.
I think that's really cool that you learned to do that in middle school. Mm-hmm. That was about the age I learned to use a camera.
See,
I started
the camera
using.
That I used was like.
Yeah, it was one of those VHS. You put the VHS tape in it and it records.
Pretty
and then
much.
You take the VHS tape yep. and edit off of that.
Yep, that's what we did.
You don't mess around with those cameras. In fact, we were lucky in high school for them to introduce Hi8, which was like a digital / tape medium. It was starting to go digital, but it was a tape still. The Hi8 was a smaller tape. So we made a movie.
I remember those, yeah.
We made a movie in high school where we all spoke in Spanish and killed each other with guns. And smoked a lot.
Water guns?
It was called Smoke and Guns. And actually, they weren't water guns. They were pop guns. But
I hate those.
Oh, yeah, they were pop guns.
My brother did one in my ear.
You probably don't like a pop gun, do you?
I don't like pop guns.
Well, I woke up
They're not my friend.
So, one last question before I yell cut and get this footage online. By the way, you look great.
Thanks.
That's my beautiful wife, everyone.
Hello,
Lucy. Aw, there's her wedding ring. Look, I got my wedding ring on. It's not on the infinite side, but there it is. Anyway, okay, so.
Yeah, both our rings have this side on them. Tell me when it's not blurry. It has the infinite sign. His has it on the right there.
There's mine. Infinity sign. I don't think the Pythagoreans would approve. No,
see,
kidding.
Mine goes all the way around. I still like this side better than this side, but this side always flips right to this side, so I can't keep it out.
I think that's neat. I think our rings are really, really neat and unique.
Yeah, they're
unique,
what
too.
What are they called?
They're not vinyl.
No. Yeah. I don't know. It's late. It's 7:30.
We'll figure out some other time and report back to the crew. All right. So anyways, they're made out of some super really cool stuff, and they're super really cool rings.
Yep.
One last question for the superhero in the frame. That is Haley.
Super Haley.
Do you have any mandrake? No, I'm kidding.
I can't tell you till you see me in the movie.
Okay, well, I guess I better send you a script then.
That would be good.
Okay, no, that wasn't my last question. This is my last question, and I'll stop bombarding you. When you did shows for middle school, did you have to both direct and star in them?
Yeah. We had a couple people who were editing who would tell me what to say, but I was doing both saying cut, action, take two, and I have this tiny little box room with this TV with what I had to say on it and the camera on top.
So you were directing it while you were acting.
I was directing. And it looked like I had a pen in my hand, but I was actually scrolling down to make sure I knew how fast I needed to go.
Perfect. Wow. So you're even running your own teleprompter. What'd you think of, one last thing, what'd you think of Mr. Bernie Lang showing up at Hearts Music? Don't you wish we had some camera battery for that event?
Pretty much. That would've been cool.
Bernie Lang, cool guy, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Nice guy, too.
Yeah, he's always been a nice guy.
Always really been super nice. Really good. He's good for our community, because he could have just ignored me and walked away, but
yeah, he took the time to remember. Cares. And I've been at 11 News with my brother there. Like, he would take me if he had to babysit me.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd help with the makeup. I'd help with plugging in the cameras and just sit in the background, being silent. And it was great stuff.
Is that how you know Arn?
Yeah. Actually,
from KKCO. Yeah.
My brother left right as he was starting.
Mm-hmm. Well,
or he was, no, not as he was starting. Pardon me. He was doing
theater work.
Yeah.
Theater work with his brother. And your dad met them doing that.
Because
your dad's got his hand in every pie.
Yeah.
The ones he didn't make himself, he's got his hands in. And it was a beautiful episode this week. Goodbye, everyone. Good night. Love you, Haley.
Mwah.
Whoa, he just knocked the camera over.
You don't mind that I'm gonna get you in there a little bit on this show.
It's all good, man.
You're gonna be on our Webisode.
He's digging it, I think.
I think you did good.
Yeah, I think it makes it like interesting.
Yes.
It's beyond interesting.
Yes.
Someday I'll have to tell you about my theory of natural idealist language progression.
Alright.
But not right now. I'm gonna write an essay about it. It's based on Kant and Wittgenstein.
How are you?
Okay. Oh, hello.
Hello.
Hello, my cousin.
What's up?
We're making Two Badass Biznitiches Part 7. It's all rules are off.
Okay.
All rules are off. No more rules.
No more rules.
We've never had any rules. We've never technically had any rules established. So actually, the first interview question I'm going to ask you is, even though there are no rules, do you think there should be rules?
No, I absolutely do not think that there should be
rules. You don't think there should be rules on any grounds?
Do you?
Not really. Maybe. I don't really think so, because, I mean, like, honestly, we're just, like, filming everything that happens, and then just, like, everyone in the world is entertained by it. It's great. I think we don't need rules for that.
Yeah, I don't think we need rules unless people are, like, getting out of control.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Like, in an unmoral way.
Like, we'd have to put laws down or something, yeah.
Yeah. Like,
if somebody did something wrong. But we don't do anything wrong.
Yeah.
We're empowering to the female, for one thing.
Yeah, we're just, like, this is how you have good...
A good adventure while driving around with a camera.
Yeah, this is how you have fun in life.
This is how you have fun with a camera and just some friends and cousins and stuff.
Woohoo!
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm all farmed out.
No, you're cool, you're cool. I may not use it. I'm just like, oh, I'm just enjoying this interesting session of you getting ready. It's an interesting session.
Is it interesting?
It is. It's the first time we've had hairspray in these movies since the first episode.
It's Kids Detangler.
Kids Detangler. That works. Well, we had a hairspray sequence in the first one, but we haven't had any hairspray since, although I had a sense that it would come back in some way or another.
Yeah.
The other day I was just going to say, like, the other day, I was watching Webisode 3, I think it was.
Okay.
And there was this part in it where we were in Victoria's Secret, and it was awesome. I mean, it was an awesome scene. It was like you were talking about how, like, even the lip gloss was too expensive there and stuff, and it was great. And it was like they did, like, every once in a while an employee would walk into the shot and smile, and they were all happy we were there. So, like, ever since that moment, I've realized there's no rules to this show.
Okay.
Because, like, we weren't kicked out or anything.
Okay.
We haven't.
You know, I went back there and I bought perfume from them because it was on sale for $5.50, and this is, like, usually $80 perfume.
Mm-hmm.
Well, like, for the big bottles. Like, the little bottles are usually $20.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I hear you. I hear you.
That's my train of thought. I don't know.
Okay, so my next... No, it's okay. What were you going to say?
I don't know. Have we been answering questions?
That was a question one. Should there be rules? And your answer basically was, yes, if things became immoral.
Yeah.
I do believe. But that, I will say, has always been a rule of mine as a filmmaker, almost always. Well, it is always that the film be moral. And not only the film be moral or have a moral to it, if the film itself isn't completely moral, it has a moral to it. And I think that serves the purposes of the supernatural forces that we call God. Because, like, God is a God of morals.
Yeah.
And he put what's right and wrong into place.
Well, I just like to be a good example for other people. Because lead by example. So, like, I don't know.
You are a good example. See, what's weird here? So here comes to question two. While we do call the show Two Badass Biznitiches, in a way, what it really is two ladies that are showing other ladies how to have a good time, right? I mean, is that fair assessment?
That's something that I like to do in my life. So I think what happened was we threw this show together. We didn't really think it through, but we're getting it done.
We're sailing on it now.
We're getting it done. And so, like...
We're sailing on it.
You know, I don't know. There might be some controversy on the title But at least we're getting some sort of message out there.
Yeah, at least somebody's seeing it and liking it. And
yeah, and hopefully, like, I don't know, like, so the titles are undecided. Like, I guess I was never sold on the title.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it kind of popped out in episode one and just became...
And it became...
The title. It just became the title.
So...
But what I like about it, and I'm like, not arguing the case for it, what I like about it is that it uses bad words in a positive way.
It does.
Which is something that I've tried to do with the use of obscenity if it is in a film. And, like, the title... really being a bad word is kind of cool, other than because that doesn't happen a lot with movies. But what I like about it is it's like what I, and the reason I think I went with it was because I was thinking about how we're basically like the exact opposite end of the spectrum of Two and a Half Men. So it's like you have Two and a Half Men who are like these two chauvinistic guys that just get laid all the time. And then with Two Badass Biznitiches, you have chicks that really don't even need dudes to have a good time.
Yeah, but then it's like...
And oh, this is Haley Michelle Atkinson, now known as somewhat as a Sheley. Yes, she's a Sheley too. And she's beautiful. She's a badass biznitch. Although that word... shouldn't be used because that's a cuss word and we're against that.
I don't like no cuss words.
So, we're here to talk to Haley, who is actually one of tonight's badass biznitches. And, we want to know, Habes, by the way, you're my wife, right?
Last time I checked.
Ooh, I got one of those too. Mm. That's why I'm wearing that.
Mm. Well, that's why you had to figure out you.
I wondered why that was on my finger.
Oh, we have a lot to go through.
We do. But a lot to go through and only 8 minutes to do it in, so let's get cracking. All right. So as far as this being the seventh episode of the show, what do you think of the show so far?
I think it's crazy awesome. Just seeing some of the shows with one of the actresses and her tutus everywhere she goes in them. I think that's funky because a lot of people wouldn't run around in tutus up and down the mall.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's really spunky and really brave. And I like her sister too. She's got great personality and I think they work together really well.
Wow. That's quite a review. Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm.
There's a few badass businesses out there, such as yourself, that are circulating their way into the show. We're trying to find new and unusual ways to do this show. If you had any recommendations for how we should take the show in what direction, what would they be?
That's a hard question. Going to the pool.
That's a good one. That's
the one in Fruita.
We'd have to go to the Fruita pool because it's
And then they have the Whirlpool or the whatever.
People may not want us to film them there, though.
Why?
Oh, because they're in their birthday suits. Everybody's in their birthday suit at the pool.
I am not naked in a pool. That's naked. Birthday suit.
I'm a little off here on my terminology. Anyway, what I'm trying to figure out, though, is if people want to be private at the pool or they want to be in the shot or whatever, we'd have to ask everybody that went by.
In the pool.
But we could probably film the Lincoln Park pool from the outside and get away with it. Like if we drove past, it's probably closed already this year.
Yeah, but it closed on Memorial Day? Labor Day?
I have no memory of Memorial Day.
I killed him. He came back to life, though.
I wondered what happened to that dude. No, I'm just kidding. But anyways, you're beautiful, by the way.
Thank you.
Isn't she beautiful, everyone? Look at that hair. That's awesome hair. Those eyes, that smile. Yes. Okay. So if you were in an hour-length webisode of Badass Biznitiches, which is probably going to happen because there's weeks we all need to rotate stuff or whatever else, and you and your friends could be in it or whatever. But if you were to do it, where would you want to go for the shoot?
I'd say the monument. And I'd pay the $7 for the day.
Wow. I'd say we need to do an episode like that with you.
Yeah.
Because...
Or we can all pay for it, like, get our...
We all chip in $250?
Yeah.
That might work. The monument. We'll look into that. We'll add it to our list of places to go.
Oh, yeah.
All right, well, you have a good night, and I thank you for helping me out. And can I have a kiss after I hit cut?
How about while?
While I'm filming?
Yes. Make sure you can see us.
My lovely wife, of who calls me every episode. When the phone rings.
Oh, shut up.
When the phone rings, you know it's her.
I call a lot. I'm sorry. I get worried.
And cut. This is Two Badass Biznitiches, Webisode 8. This is a cool shot. I wonder how it's going to look in black and white. But anyway, on with the Halloween episode. And cut. Action.
This are you getting for the screen?
A lot.
You mean like everything?
Yeah. Action. End cut. Action. Cut.
Actually, now that fell, it's much better.
Action.
Fuck this first draft. Bullshit. Fuck it.